गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास इफ यू हैव हर्ड माय वीडियो, इट हैड म्यूटेड फ्रॉम द 12th मिनट बिकॉज ऑफ द रीजन ऑफ सम प्रॉब्लम विद द सॉफ्टवेयर. सो आई विल बी जस्ट एक्सप्लेनिंग, आई वाज एक्सप्लेनिंग द प्रोग्राम दैट टाइम. इट वाज नॉट ऑडिबल आफ्टर सम टाइम, सो आई विल जस्ट एक्सप्लेन इट अगेन. सो इट इज़ जनरेशन ऑफ ट्रायंगुलर वेव फ्रॉम द डैक. सो द फर्स्ट थिंग इज यू हैव टू कॉल द include you have to include the header file, then you have to you have to define a variable called val under the unsigned integer 32 bit. And from the main program, first we call the first we have to call the system init, that is a function which will configure the clock. And then we have to, as I had said in the previous video, the each pin of the ARM Cortex M3 have different functionalities. There are four functionalities for each pin. Apart from working like a GPIO, it can work like other functions also. So to select a function of a particular pin, we have different pin select register. So that is 0 1 2 3 4, and then this pin select 1 is register is used to select the function of 0.26, which is used like an LED also, and now it is used like an DAC output. So here to do that, pin select 1, 20th and 21st are used as a bits to represent the function of that P0.26. How is it done is, now suppose 20th and 21st bit, if you make them 00, it will be used like a GPIO. Okay, then if it is 01, it will be used like another function. Then 10, it will be used like a DAC output, and 11 may be an another function. So 20th and 21st bit we have to make 10, that is 21st bit have to make 1 and 20th bit have to make 0. So if you make that pin select 0.26 pin work like a DAC output. So how to do that is, LPC underscore pincon is an API where we have defined this pin select 1 register. So we have to go to that API. In that API there is a register defined to be pin select 1. So LPC underscore pincon, in that pin select 1 or equal to 2 is moved with 20 times. 2, if you convert into binary, it is 10. When you move this to 20 times, what it will be, 21st bit will be 1 and 20th bit will be 0. So you are making the P0.26 pin as the DAC output. Then we enter into the while loop, while 1, this is an infinite loop. Again, we have one more while loop wherein we increment the value. So value plus plus is nothing but increment the value of value by 1. So LPC underscore DAC is another API where number of DAC registers are defined. So that is DACR is defined in the LPC underscore DAC API. So LPC underscore DAC, DACR is equal to, value is moved 6 times. Why it is moved 6 times? Because DACR register holds the value from 6th to 15th. So whatever value is there in VAL, that we have to move 6 times. So whatever the data is there will be moved into the bits of 6th to 15th. So once you do that, we have to check whether it has reached the maximum value, and that maximum value is nothing but 1024 here. 1024 because the DAC what we have in LPC 1768 is a 10-bit DAC. 10-bit DAC is 2 raised to 10 is 1024. So maximum value it can generate is 1024 analog output. So if it reaches that 1024, it has to break that and go to the next while loop. In the next while loop, value is decremented. Now imagine that you are incrementing the value continuously, so you will generate a increasing line. Okay, you have reached the maximum value. Now what we are doing is we are decreasing continuously till it reaches 0. So can you see that it will be looking like a triangular? So increasing continuously, then stops, then again decreases, then stops and again increases. So it's like a triangular waveform. Okay, so and this will happen continuously since everything you have written in the while loop. Next is the square wave generation. Again, you have to include the LPC underscore the LPC 17xs.h header file. Then here we have introduced one delay. It's a subroutine, or you can say a function wherein you introduce a delay. And you have already seen in the previous programs how to write the delay program. So we have two for loops here with the two variables I and j. Second for loop with respect to j is written with a semicolon. It means that after for loop there are no instructions. It means that the for loop will execute until j reaches 2000. So once it reaches 2000, it will go to the outer for loop, increments the value of I and checks again with the ms. So this will continue until I reaches ms. Okay, so there is a kind of delay introduced in the program. Then you go to the main program, call the system init operation function. Then again we have to select the pin, select one register pins. You have to make 20th and 21st bit as 10, to make 0.26 pin as the DAC output. So that's what we have done here. Then again while one, in this while one there are only two values we are putting into the DAC register. What are these values? The maximum value and the minimum value. So square wave, right? So maximum value is FFFF, we are putting into DACR register, and call some delay. Why delay? Because see, once you have put the value of DACR with FFFF, it has to stay there for some time, right? So it has to produce that FF value for some duration so that you get an on pulse. Similarly, you have to put 0 again into the DAC register. So from FFF, it will directly jump to 0 and stay there for some time. So that is called off pulse. So this will be continuously happening, and so you get a square wave. Okay, so this is about the DAC register. Fine. So let us now go for another program where we have to generate a PWM wave. A PWM waveform is a pulse width modulated waveform. Okay, now how does this pulse width modulated waveform looks? I'll just show here. It is PWM signal. This is what a PWM signal looks, a pulse width modulator. So what is the meaning here is, okay, so the width of the pulse will be continuously changing. Okay, so it is like I'll just show you with an image. You can see here. So the width of the pulse will be continuously changing with respect to the analog signal. Okay, so this is a PWM signal. You have a message signal, you have a carrier signal. Now if you see, as the signal is increasing here, okay, as the signal is increasing here, the PWM waveform width is also increasing and reaches the maximum point when the signal is highest. Okay, that is the maximum amplitude. So as the signal is reducing, the width of the pulse is also reducing and reaches the minimum width in the negative mean, minimum, that is least value. Okay, so this is how it works. This is how the PWM signal is. Okay, so this PWM signal can be generated in the LPC1768 board. Okay, and how we can generate this is, there are different PWM modules already built inside the LPC1768 boards, and there are 6 modules of PWM. Okay, can you imagine? There are 6 modules of PWM, and it can generate simultaneously 6 PWM signals which can be used for different applications. And one of the application where we use this PWM signal in our lab is to rotate the DC motor. Okay, so to rotate the DC motor, we are making use of this PWM concept. So it is bit difficult for you all to understand here when with this kind of teaching. If it was on the board, I could have explained it more well, but I'll try my level best to explain it. To explain it and make you all understand about it. So as I said, the PWM module of LPC1768 can generate 6 PWM signals. Okay, so you can see here, it was told that LPC1768 has 6 PWM output pins which can be used as a single 6-ended edged or the 3-double-edged. And there are even a match register to support these PWM register. There is something called as match register. I'll tell you what is the meaning of match register. And here in the below, this table will tell you how many channels of PWM are present, and they are on which port pin. Okay, and which
pin, how to function that particular pin using what register, and then associated pin select register. So as I said, the LPC 1768 ARM Cortex M3 has number of output, input and output lines. By default, they will be working like a GPIO. Okay, but each of the pins have different functionalities. Now there are four functions for each of the pin. One of the function what we saw earlier was DAC. Okay, another type of function we can have an example is PWM. So here you can see PWM channels, how many channels are there? There are six channels, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, and where are these channels, with on what pins they are available? 2.0, 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4 and 2.4 continuously. So 0 to 5 of port 2 have the signals PWM1 to PWM6. Okay, what are the pin functions of this port pins, that is 2.0 to 2.5? Are normally they work like a GPIO. So you can see here 0 means what? It is GPIO. 1 means it is a PWM signal. 2 means some transmitter. 3 means something else. So if you see each pin of 2.0 or 2.1 or 2.8 or 2.5, all of them have four functionalities. 0 means GPIO, 1 means a different function, 2 means a different, 3 means a different function. So here in the all the pins of this 2.0 to 2.5, 1 means a PWM channels from 1 to 6. Otherwise, they will be normally working like a GPIO pin if it is 0. Okay, now to make this 2.0 as a PWM signal, we know that we have to do some changes in the pin select register. And which pin select register we are using for the selection of PWM here is, we are using pin select 4. So we are used pin select 1 in DAC. Now we are using pin select 4. So by changing the bits of pin select 4, we will be changing the function of the port bits 2.0 to 2.5. Okay, now what are the bits of pin select are associated with these pins? Okay, so 0 and 1 bits of pin select 4 are associated with 2.0. So if you want to make a 2.0 pin as a PWM channel, what you have to do, you have to move 0 and 1 bit, we have to move it 0 1. 1 if you convert into binary, it will be 0 1. 2 if you convert into binary, it is 1 0. 3 if you convert into binary, it's 1 1. Now it's 1 means PWM1, right? If you convert binary, it will be 0 1. So 0 1 bits of pin select 4 register has to be moved with 0 1. Okay, so I hope you understood. I'll just explain it again. Okay, so here there will be fine. So there will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on till 31. So there will, suppose this is a pin select 4. This is pin select 4 from 0 to 31. 0 and 1 are dedicated for PWM 1. 2 and 3 are dedicated for PWM 2. Similarly, 4 and 5 are dedicated for PWM 3 and so on. Okay, now what we have to do here is, in the case of, just a minute. So if you have to, select a PWM 1 channel, suppose 0 and 1. Bits are used of pin select 4 for selection of P2.0 as PWM. So 0 1, as we saw, 0 means GPIO, 1 means PWM, 2 means some transmitter, 3 means it is some other function. So 1 means it is PWM. So 1 if you convert into binary, it will be 0 1. So this 0 1 value we have to put here in this way. Okay, so 0 1 is put into the bits of 0 1. Now suppose the next bit are 2 3. Suppose I want to keep 2.1. okay, instead of 2.0, it is 2.1, that is second PWM channel. So then in that case, 2 and 3 should be made 0 1. 0 1 means again in this case as 0 1. Got it? So this is how we have to do it. Okay, and then similarly, if you want to make it as GPIO, we have to make it both 00. It means the 2.1 will be working like a GPIO. Okay, so this is how it works. This is how we have to select a particular pin for PWM channel. And then the way you had registers in DAC, there are number of registers defined even for the PWM signal. Okay, there are many registers starting with IR, TC, that is interrupt register, timer cut register, timer counter, T-scalar register, PC, MCR, MR0, MR1 to MR6, PCR and LER. So MR1 to MR6 are called the match register. So one by one, let us see which all registers we'll be using for writing the program here. First one we are not using, which is an interrupt register. So it is nothing but like when we have a PWM signal, there will be an interrupt produced here, and to writing a logic 1 on this, the IR can be read to identify which of the 8 possible interrupt sources are pending, and writing 1 to the will clear the corresponding interrupt. So we will neglect it since we are not using. And next one is the time control register. This is the register where we enable or disable or reset the control timer value. So there is a timer associated with this PWM signal, okay, which will be continuously increasing. So that value we have to enable. Then we have timer counter, that is TC. It's a 32-bit TC and is incremented every PR plus 1 cycle. PR is nothing but T-scalar value. So every PR plus 1 cycle, this value will be incremented. Okay, and TC is controlled through the TCR. So when you enable this, only when this timer counter starts incrementing. Then there is a pre-scalar register. Pre-scalar register is nothing but from where you want to start this PWM signal. Sometimes we want it to start at 0 level, or sometimes we want it to start at some other level, right? So if whatever value you want to start, that value you have to put it into pre-scalar register. In our program, we are keeping this as 0 itself. So we are starting the PWM signal from the 0th instant only. Then we have pre-scalar counter. It is a 32-bit PC, that is pre-scalar counter. It's a counter which is increment to the value stored in PR. Okay, so whatever the value stored in PR, this 32-bit value will be incremented to the value stored in PR when the value of this PR is reached. Okay, then the TC is incremented. Okay, so this is used with the pre-scalar. Then MCR, match control register, it is used to reset the timer control value, that is the TC value, when there is a match occurs. Match occurs is nothing but we have 6 match registers as MR1 to MR6 associated with the each PWM signal. So when these match registers will hold the match value, when the MCR used to control the resetting of TC, it has the TC value has to be reset when this MR1 to MR6 reaches the match register. And match register is nothing but MR0. This register usually holds the duty cycle. Okay, and then MR0 will hold the maximum duty cycle, and MR1 will hold the match register, okay, hold the match value, PWM duty, fine. And a PCR is nothing but it is used to control the PWM. So how do we control is whether we enable the PWM efforts or selection of the PWM channel is all done through the PCR register. Okay, load enable we are not using in this program, so we will neglect it. So now let us see one by one each register in the next class. Just before that, I have already sent this, before going to the program in the next video. There are only 2 minutes left. So before going to the next video, what you can do is just go through again this the theory of PWM, that is what registers are used and how the registers are helpful in generating a PWM signal. And there are steps given here document we have shared with you for writing the journal. In that, everything is there, how to configure the PWM signal. Okay, so those all things are there apart from the program. So you can study that before I go to the next video. Okay, thank you.